we want to solve the polynomial inequality, which is given in factored form. To solve this means to find all the x values for which this product on the left is less than 0. We'll solve this by hand and also check it graphically. The first step in solving this inequality is to determine which x values make this product equal to 0. We'll use those values to form intervals on the number line and then test to see which interval actually satisfies the given inequality. So again, the first step is to solve the equation, the quantity x plus 4 times the quantity x plus 1 times the quantity x minus 5 equals 0. Well, x minus 4 is equal to 0 when x equals negative 4. X plus 1 is equal to 0 when x equals negative 1. And x minus 5 is equal to 0 when x equals 5. So these are the x values that make this product equal to 0. But we want the values of x where this is less than 0. Notice when this product is equal to 0, it does not satisfy this inequality. 0 is not less than 0. So when we plot these points on the number line, we're going to make open points to show that these are not part of the solution. If this was less than or equal to, then these values would satisfy the inequality, and we'd make closed points. But because it's less than, we're going to make open points on negative 4, negative 1, and positive 5. Notice by plotting these three points, we now have four intervals to test. We have the interval on the left, this interval here, and the interval on the right. So now what we're going to do is pick test values in each interval and see if it satisfies the inequality. If the test value satisfies the inequality, the interval is part of the solution. If it doesn't, the interval is not part of the solution. So let's test x equals negative 5 to the left. And here let's go ahead and test x equals negative 2. Here we'll test 0. And here we'll test 6. When x equals negative 5, here we'd have negative 5 plus 4, that's negative 1. Negative 5 plus 1 is negative 4.
And negative 5 minus 5 is equal to negative 10.
We want to know if this is less than 0.
This will be negative 40. Notice how we have an odd number of negatives, and negative 40 is less than 0.
Which means this interval here is part of the solution. Let's go ahead and graph it. Next, we'll test x equals negative 2. So we would have negative 2 plus 4, that's 2. Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. Negative 2 minus 5 is negative 7. Well, here we have positive 14 is less than 0. That's false, which means the interval from negative 4 to negative 1 is false. Let's go ahead and just write that in there. It's false. Now we'll test x equals 0. Well, when x is 0, we would have positive 4 times positive 1 times negative 5 less than 0. This is negative 20 is less than 0, which is true. Since this is true, this interval here is part of the solution, so we'll go ahead and graph that. And now the last test value was x equals 6. So we'd have 6 plus 4, that's 10, times 6 plus 1 is 7, times 6 minus 5 is 1. So it looks like we have 70 is less than 0, that's false. So the interval on the right here is also false, or not part of the solution. So this graph represents the x values that satisfy this inequality. Let's also give the solution using interval notation and using inequalities. So as we move to the left, we approach negative infinity. So using interval notation, we'd have the interval from negative infinity to negative 4. It's open on negative 4 because it does not include negative 4. Union the open interval from negative 1 to positive 5. Or using inequalities, we could say x is less than negative 4, or x is greater than negative 1 and less than 5. So we can express the solution any of these three ways, using interval notation, using inequalities, or using a graph. But let's also verify our solution graphically. To check this graphically, we want to analyze the graph of f of x equals the quantity x plus 4 times the quantity x plus 1 times the quantity x minus 5. To know when the product here is less than 0, by graphing this function, we want to know when the function is less than 0. Remember, function values are y values, so f of x is less than 0.
When the y values are negative, or when the function is below the x-axis.
Looking at the graph, notice how the function is below the x-axis here, and from here to here. But our solution is in terms of x, so if we project this onto the x-axis, notice how this left piece is below the x-axis when x is less than negative 4. We don't include negative 4 because that's when this would be equal to 0. We want to know when it's less than 0. And then we also have the interval from negative 1 to 5 along the x-axis, again, not including the endpoints. So these intervals along the x-axis match our solution from the previous slide, verifying our work is correct.